This is NEXI. NEXI is a componentized 3D printed chair in its prototype stages. In this version, its connectors and nodes are printed from PLA plastic, and its continuous seat and back will be made from a fabric canvas. This project has been a work in progress for several years, but I wanted to make a video showing some things I've learned along the way in case others were interested in doing something similar. For this design, I used Sketchup because I felt like it gave me the most control over the geometry that I wanted to explore. The nodes, or NEXI, which is plural for nexus, vary from hosting 2 to 3, or in some cases, up to 5 connectors. Each node is a component comprised of several minimal surfaces. And those surfaces were created using the Soap, Skin, and Bubble SketchUp plugin, which is linked in the description. You can see here all the individual soap skin surfaces that make up one of the most complex nodes of the chair. For this first prototype, all of the connections are made using a mortise and tenon joint, leaving at least a 1/16 of an inch between all surfaces, including the butt joint. This allowed for flexibility in the print tolerances, and all connections will be made secure using a cyanoacrylate glue. A link to this glue, which is called Zap-a-gap, is included in the video description. Remember, the quality and the strength of the print is dependent on the print's orientation. Once all the nodes and connectors were printed, I did a dry test fit to assess the connections. I was surprised to discover that most connections were secure with friction alone. This inspired me to explore a more permanent friction-only connection by using a snap-fit connection. These will be incorporated into a future prototype. The continuous seat and back were also modeled in SketchUp. The geometry is flattened so that it can be printed and cut at full scale to be used as a template. The canvas seat will be secured to the frame using snap button fasteners. For those interested, these renderings were done in Revit. And to conclude, I just wanted to rotate the model around so that you can take a closer look at the connectors, the nodes, the joints, the tolerances, and the geometry. For those experimenting with this componentized approach to 3D printing furniture or assembling architecture, it's important to remember to model all details using real-world tolerances. This is especially important when applied to parts that experience either temporary or prolonged stresses, such as these snap fittings. I've included a link in the description to a design guideline that specifically addresses 3D printed parts that experience stress. Here's a look at the prototype in its current state as it's being assembled and assessed for quality. I'll post a follow-up video once the prototype chair is complete and ready for its debut. Thanks for watching, and let me know if you have any questions or comments.